my dreams I've kissed your lips a thousand times. I sometimes see you pass outside my door.
Hello. Relax, I know what I'm doing. Recently I did a show for the United Nations and I started off by saying, so where are you all from? To be honest, there wasn't much time for anything else. As a child, I had a medical condition that meant I had to eat soil 3 times a day in order to survive. Lucky my older brother told me about it, really. He later died of massive head injuries. But then you are more likely to get injured if you've got a massive head. I used to think that sticks and stones could break my bones, but words could never hurt me until I fell into a printing press. It's difficult to know sometimes whether you remember something or you remember the photograph of something. I think my earliest memory is of being in America, standing over an air vent and my skirt billowing up. When I was in America, I really got into the culture. I went into a shop and the guy said, "Have a nice day," and I didn't, so I sued him. If there'd been a mix-up, my uncle could have ended up as an ex-president of the United States. He's an undertaker in the army, or Barack Obama. So if you're being chased by a police dog, try not to go through a tunnel, then onto a little seesaw, then jump through a hoop of fire. Because they train for that. Don't go camping in the countryside. Have you noticed whenever the police find a body, it's always in a tent? Years ago, of course, I used to supply filofaxes for the mafia. Yeah, I was involved in very organized crime. I come from a family of police marksmen. I think that was a reaction against my grandfather. He was a bank robber. He died quite recently, surrounded by his family. My other grandfather, he was a peeping Tom. He used to drill holes in the floor and spy on the people in the flat below. But he died quite recently. But I like to think of him as up there somewhere. Looking down on us. My other grandfather. He's a bit of a man for the ladies. Doesn't matter how clearly the gents are signposted. My other grandfather, he can't do what he used to, bless him, you know, bomb the Japanese. My other grandfather, he would never ever throw anything away, but he died in the war holding on to a hand grenade. My other grandfather, there's nothing unusual about him. Don't know why I brought him up, really. My other grandfather, When he died, we didn't even get the chance to say goodbye, which was all the more poignant because he drowned in a bowl of Cheerios. My grandmother... is confused. My nephew, when he grows up, he wants to be an accountant, so... there he is. You obviously gave him some helium. My nephew, when he grows up, he wants to be an accountant, so for his birthday, I bought him a great big bag of receipts. I said, listen, don't worry if you don't like them. I've kept all the presents. I don't know if any of you have been skiing, but then how would I? They said about me that I was too immature to be a father. But when I saw the first few seconds of my son's life, I thought to myself, he's naked. When my daughter was born, she had jaundice. So there she was, small, round, and yellow. We called her Melanie. I tell you what's a dangerous insect. Is that hepatitis B? I tell you what's a dangerous place to swim. Is that hepatitis C? You know, when you're in a relationship, what's that like? I'd like to finish with a prayer, the prayer Jesus taught us. Hang on a minute, some people are thinking, Jesus had a tortoise? Went home for Christmas this year, couldn't get in the door. Too many granddads. I leave you tonight with this. If you're being interrogated by the police, perhaps tonight, and they're recording the interview, just make sure that every so often you go, ow. That's it. That's all for me. Thank you very much. Good night. Thank you.